We've learned how to define detector geometry in GM4. We also learned how to shoot different particles into our detector. Will GM4 take care of the rest by itself? After all, the rest is just physics. Well, historically, you will have to build up your own physics list from scratch. This is simply too much for a regular user. Nowadays, you don't have to do it anymore, thanks to a tool called Physics List Factory, which allows you to choose a predefined physics list by its name. So now, as a normal user, your responsibility is to choose one from a list of options. Before we learn how to choose a proper physics list for your GM4 simulation, let's spend some time to go through the terminology to build up the common language for our discussion. A physics list is a list of possible physics processes associated with a certain particle. Let's take a gamma ray as an example. When it gets into your detector, one of the three processes may happen. It may transfer all its energy to an electron, or get scattered a few times, or be converted into a pair of electron and a positron. The photoelectric effect is more likely to happen when the gamma ray energy is low, while the pair production is more likely to happen at higher energies. A physics process is a combination of a model which describes what happens in a certain energy range, and a cross-section which describes how often it happens. A GM4 simulation may involve many different types of particles. Each of them has an associated physics list. We can pack all these physics lists together into modules, and we can have a module for electromagnetic interactions, a module for weak interactions, another one for strong interactions. Of course, you can create your own modular list. However, GM4 provides some pre-packaged official modular lists. Some of them are well maintained and tested. They are called reference lists. A physics list factory is a GM4 class that can be used to call pre-packaged lists by their names. Pre-packaged lists can be found in the GM4 source code physics-lists/lists/src directory. There are quite a few options here. How do you know which one you need to choose? Well, chances are that you don't have to choose. Take Gears as an example. The default physics list in Gears is QGSP_BERT, which is good enough for most of the simulations. What does QGSP-BERT mean? They are just names of different hydronic physics models. The first one before the underscore applies for a bit higher energies. The second one applies for lower energies. If you would like to simulate neutrons, it better enable high precision neutron model by attaching underscore HP at the end of the physics list name. The electromagnetic physics list can be chosen by attaching another suffix to the hydronic physics list name. If you do not attach any suffix, you are using the standard. Gears provides a macro command called physics lists select for you to choose a pre-packaged physics list by its name. In this specific example, we use a physics model dedicated to low background experiments with a high precision ENM model based on Livermore data. This command must be used before run initialize. Otherwise, the standard physics list will be initialized. You can then use the command run beam on to dump detailed information about the physics list on your screen. It shows in detail what kind of physics models are applied in which energy range to what kind of particles. The output is overwhelmingly long. This is a not problem for a typical terminal in the Mac or Linux machine. However, the standard GM4 GUI for Windows does not store enough history in its output buffer. If you scroll up enough, you'll see that some of the old outputs are missing. While this is not a problem for a Linux terminal, the solution is to run Gears in a PowerShell instead of a normal command interface. The Windows PowerShell stores enough history for you to scroll back. A physics list contains a lot of physics processes. They can be categorized into 5 categories: electromagnetism, weak interactions, hadronic physics, parameterized physics for fast simulation, and transportation. Strictly speaking, transportation is not a physics process. It is used to deal with scenarios like when a particle passes from one physics volume into another. A simulation step is added artificially at the point where the particle trajectory passes through the boundary. This feature can be used to visualize the profile of a physics volume or to count number of particles passing through a surface. We're going to mention radioactive decay of nuclei and optical photon tracking in later classes. Today we're going to focus on simulation of E&M physics and a little bit on neutron simulation. Let's start with alpha particles. Alpha particles, or ions in general, are heavy electrically charged particles. They mainly interact with matter through Coulomb forces between their positive charges and the negative charge of orbiting electrons. Although interactions of the particle with nuclei are also possible, such encounters occur only rarely and they are not normally significant in the response of radiation detectors. The following processes are assigned to an alpha in the physics list. Multiple scattering, or MSC in short in GM4, where an alpha changes its direction without ionizing other atoms. Ionization, where an alpha changes its direction and creates secondary electrons. If the created electrons are energetic enough, they are called delta rays. In scintillating materials, an alpha track can emit scintillation light. It can also elastic or inelastically scatter against a nucleus. A macro file, ragcurve.mac, is shipped together with Gears to demonstrate the simulation of 5.5 MeV alphas flying through air. One can see that most alpha particles go straight. This is because the chance for an alpha particle to be scattered in a large angle by a nucleus is rare. The fluffy red hair around a blue alpha particle track are electrons. They are the result of alpha particle ionizing surrounding atoms. Alpha particles lose their energy along their way through ionization and stop around the same location, because slow alphas are easier to be stopped by Coulomb force. Beta particles are electrons. They lose their energies in matter primarily through ionizing atoms around them below 10 MeV. More energetic electrons are more likely to generate photons through bremsstrahlung. And multiple scattering with orbiting electrons is a subdominant way for an electron to lose energy. A macro file can be found in Gears Examples Physics beta directory to demonstrate the simulation of 2 MeV electrons passing through air. They can fly much further than alpha particles, but their directions are much easier to be changed. The green lines here are gamma rays generated by bremsstrahlung process. Gamma rays are much more penetrating than alpha and beta particles. We've talked about 3 interactions gamma rays can do in matter and their relative significance in different energy ranges. Another macro file is shipped with Gears to demonstrate the simulation of 2 MeV gamma rays flying through air. they can fly really far and get scattered one or twice in different angles. The Curly spaghetti are electrons generated by gamma rays in one of the three interactions. Now let's use neutron interactions as an example to talk about quadronic physics. Slow neutrons are very easy to be captured by a nucleus. The exciting nucleus will emit a gamma ray to de-excite. For neutrons at medium energy range, they can scatter elastically or inelastically against nuclei. A very high energetic neutron can induce fission in the nucleus and break it into pieces. There is a comprehensive example demonstrates the simulation of 14 MeV neutrons from a DT generator shot to a concrete block in gears. The high-precision neutron model is used in the simulation by attaching HP to the standard physics list name. A very useful GM4 macro command is called tracking variables 2. It is used to enable printing information on screen about what's happening for a particle when it passes through the detector. In this concrete example, a neutron is transported from its original location to a concrete block and start to elastically scatter against many protons inside the material. The protons gains energy from the original neutron and loses its own energy primarily by hadronic ionization process. Since this command dumps a lot of information on screen, I only turn it on for a few events, just for debugging. After that, I turn the visualization and this option off so that I can start the simulation of a lot of events.